let's talk about superposition and how we can use it to solve circuits. In this circuit, we see that we have a current source and a voltage source. Because it has two sources, and in very simple terms, each of these resistors gets some voltage and current from each source. In other words, there is an effect on the resistors from each of these sources. For example, the current and voltage values of this resistor are these with both sources. But if we remove this voltage source, our current and voltage changes. Now instead, if we remove the current source, then our current and voltage changes to this. But notice, again, in very simple terms, each of these sources gave a portion of voltage and a portion of current. So if we were to figure out each of these portions from each individual source and then add it all together, we get the full picture. That's what superposition is all about. If we have one source to solve instead of two, that makes it pretty easy to solve this circuit, right? And that's the reason to use superposition. Each of these sources will provide some current and voltage to the circuit. So all we do is focus on a single source at a time. When we remove a source, if it's a voltage source, we replace it with a short circuit, and if it's a current source, we replace it with an open circuit. So here, we would replace the voltage source with a short circuit like this, and figure out the values we want. Then we would put the voltage source back and ignore the current source by having an open circuit. We would calculate the values for our unknowns. Once we get both values, all we do is add them together and we get the true values. There are some things to keep in mind when using the superposition method. Superposition works for circuits with passive elements like resistors because they're linear. Also, you can only find the current and voltage, not power, using superposition, because power dissipation is a nonlinear function. Most of the time, circuits can be solved just by combining resistors in parallel or series and using voltage or current division when only a single source is present. But that doesn't mean you can't use any other method you want. For example, you can use mesh analysis or nodal analysis on a circuit with a single source and still get the values you want. It's totally up to you. Don't worry, all of this will make so much more sense when we cover examples, so let's get to it. Let's start with a nice and simple example. Here, we need to find I0, so the current flowing through this 6k ohm resistor using superposition. The first step is to pick a source that we want to remove. Let's pick the voltage source first. Since it's a voltage source we're removing, we replace it with a short circuit. From this point on, the method you want to use to solve for the current is completely up to you. But we can easily solve it by noticing that these two resistors are parallel to each other, and the combination of that is in series to this resistor. So our circuit would look like this, which is a single node pair circuit. I have a whole video on combining resistors in parallel and in series, so if you need a refresh, I highly encourage you to take a look at that video first. Using current division, we can figure out the current in the 6k ohm resistor. In current division, the top of the fraction is the resistor current we don't want, and the bottom is the addition of the two resistor values in the circuit. So here, we want the current in the 6k ohm resistor, so the 9k ohm resistor goes on top. We get 3.6 milliamps. Again, current division and voltage division was thoroughly talked about in the combining resistors video, so if you need a refresh, please watch that video first. Note here that k represents 1000, and the m represents 10 to the negative 3. This makes it easier to write values down, rather than writing 9,000 ohms or 6,000 ohms. So this current value we found is the current that will flow through the 6k ohm resistor with just the 6 milliampere current source in the circuit. We will label it I0(1). Next, we put the voltage source back and remove the current source. When we remove the current source, we replace it with an open circuit. So here, that would just mean the whole conductor is gone. So now, we need to figure out I0 again with the voltage source in the circuit. To solve this circuit, we can use voltage division, but let's go with mesh analysis. The method you use is completely up to you and what you feel comfortable with. I do want to point out that one of the main points of superposition is to reduce the number of simultaneous equation solving, but again, the method you use is up to you. We can pick both mesh currents to be clockwise. Let's write our first mesh equation for current I1. We have the 12-volt source. We enter the negative terminal, so it's negative 12. Then we have 6k times the mesh current I1. And lastly, we have two mesh currents in this branch. And since we're writing our mesh current for I1, we get I1 minus I2, since I2 is flowing in the opposite direction to I1. Let's simplify. That's our first equation. Now we can write one for the second mesh. We have 6k ohms times I2, and another 6k ohms times I2, and lastly, we have the shared mesh currents in this branch. And this time, we're writing the mesh current for I2, so we get I2 minus I1, since I1 is now opposing the direction of I2. Let's simplify. That's our second equation. I have a complete guide to mesh analysis, so if you want to refresh, please take a look at that video. Now we can use elimination to solve these equations. If we multiply the second equation by 2 and add it to the first equation, it will eliminate I1. We get 0.4 milliamps for I2, and we don't even need to solve for I1, since I2 is the same as I0 because it's the same branch current. So the current that flows through the 6k ohm resistor with just the voltage source is 0.4 milliamps. We will label that I0 2. Now that we have the current flowing through the resistor from both sources, all we need to do is add them together. We get 4 milliamps, and thus the current flowing through the resistor with both sources in the circuit. Let's take a look at this question where we need to find V0 using superposition. So let's start by removing the voltage source. These two resistors are parallel to each other. Now we see this resistor is in series with this one. So our circuit will look like this. This is a node pair circuit, so we can use current division to figure out the current in the top 2k ohm resistor. We get 3.6 milliamps, and using that, we can figure out the voltage of the resistor. So with Ohm's law, we get 3.6 milliamps times 2k, giving us 7.2 volts. So that's the voltage in this resistor with just the current source. Now we put the voltage source back and remove the current source. To figure out V0, we can use mesh analysis. Both will go clockwise. So let's write our first equation for current I1. Now we can simplify. That's our first equation. Next, we can write another equation for mesh current I2. Let's simplify. That's our second equation. Now we can use elimination to solve for I2. So let's multiply equation 2 by 2 and then add it to our first equation. We get negative 1.2 milliamps, so mesh current 2 flows counterclockwise. That doesn't matter right now, since we're given the positive sign of V0 to be on the left side. So the question is assuming the current is flowing left to right, in other words, clockwise. Let's find the voltage by multiplying the current by the resistance. We get negative 2.4 volts, and again, that's because we're given the positive side of the resistor to be on the left, but the current actually flows right to left. Now all that's left is to add our two voltage sources together. So the voltage of the resistor with both sources in the circuit is 4.8 volts, and that's our answer. Let's take a look at this problem where we need to find V0 using superposition. So we can start by removing the voltage sources and figuring out the voltage of the resistor with just the current source. Something really interesting happens when we do this. Notice how this creates a short circuit between this point and this point. That means the current will not flow into any of these resistors at the bottom of our circuit. It will take the easiest path by going through this loop and this loop. So right away, we know the voltage in this resistor is zero, with just the current source. Next, we remove the current source along with one of the voltage sources. In this configuration, we see that these two resistors are series to each other, and the two on the bottom are parallel to each other. So combining the resistors gives us a circuit that looks like this. Now we can easily use voltage division or mesh analysis to get the voltage. But guess what we will use? That's right, mesh analysis. It's good practice. We will pick both mesh currents to go counterclockwise. Let's write our equation for mesh current 2. We can directly solve for the current. We get 2.4 milliamps. Using this value, we can figure out the voltage. Now the voltage we found is true for both of these resistors, since the voltage is the same for resistors in parallel. However, there is something to keep in mind. Notice how we're given the positive side to be on top, while the negative sign is on the bottom. When we found I2, we assumed current to enter here. So that means we assume the positive side to be here. However, that's opposing what the question is giving us. In other words, the current enters the assumed negative terminal of our resistor. That means V02 is equal to negative 1.2 volts. The last source we need to consider is the left side voltage source. In this circuit, these two resistors are in series, and these two are parallel to each other. So this is what our circuit looks like after combining resistors. Now we can solve this using voltage division or mesh analysis. So let's go with mesh analysis. This time, we can pick both currents to be clockwise. Let's write an equation for mesh current 2. Now we can directly solve for the current. We get 7.2 milliamps. So using this value, we can figure out the voltage in the resistor. So with this voltage source, the voltage in our resistor is 7.2 volts. The last step is to combine all of the voltage values we got. With all three sources, the voltage in the resistor is 6 volts, and that's our answer. That should cover the types of problems you will face when it comes to solving circuits using superposition. Thanks for watching, and best of luck with your studies.